Hi, folks, and welcome to BioWare Follower. So BioWare threw a curveball at us and released a bunch of stuff with a new patch. So let's get right to it and dive into all the new developments for Mass Effect Andromeda. Starting with the most obvious, we now have Batarians in multiplayer. Now we know this because BioWare was nice enough to release a trailer alongside the patch, putting particular emphasis on the Batarians, why they're here, and how they kick amazing amounts of ass. It was a great touch to have Kandros narrate this trailer. Gives a nice bit of continuity for the fans. And Maker knows you're gonna need the Batarians to kick some major ass with a new Platinum difficulty in the multiplayer. This difficulty looks ready to bring a whole new level of challenge to the multiplayer, and we can't wait to try it out. And probably get the snot kicked out of us. But hey, that's part of the fun, right? Just to quickly round up all the other improvements to multiplayer, specifically, the Tactical Cloak melee damage bonus now applies to the jump melee as well. There's improved stability, and before everyone starts jumping on the lack of story DLC or single-player content, don't worry. There were a lot of fixes to the single-player too, including, but not limited to, even more tweaks and fixes to the facial animations and cinematics. Many issues with quest progression lockers and markers were resolved, plus they fixed a rather hilarious glitch where Ryder can be killed on Aya, even after following instructions from the Angara. They also fixed a glitch where Ryder could commit to relationships with Jahl and Korra at the same time. Well, you call it a glitch, I call it heaven. And they finally addressed some issues surrounding PB's loyalty mission, specifically some saving and loading issues and triggering failures. And speaking of loyalty missions, they fixed that bug where a save and load during Drak's loyalty mission could cause the final platform to disappear. Moving on, the X-5 can now finally be dismantled. The issue of being attacked during the initial talk with Bane Masani on Eos has been fixed, as well as the ledge trap in the Elidan vault where Ryder could become stuck. There's also a few additions to make for a more comfortable experience. For instance, for those with itchy clicker fingers, there's an added prompt before changing Ryder's appearance on the Tempest. There was an issue where the player couldn't progress through the final story mission if the Nomad was broken from the Out of Gas quest, which has now been fixed. As has the weird glitch where the auto level would assign skill points to the loyalty locked squad power. And let's see a show of hands, where are all my fellow Vetra fans at? That Speak to Cid objective that would keep popping up even after you'd already been to see her has now been fixed. So now I can finally resent Cid for her actions instead of a glitch. Oh, and for the PC peeps out there, the issues with the Logitech key bindings have been resolved, along with improvements to the HDR functionality on the Windows 10 Creators update. And that's about it. We'll put a link to the full patch notes in the description if you want to peruse it at your own leisure. But for now, what do you guys think of the inclusion of the Batarians? Does it mean that single-player DLC is on the horizon? What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments, and we'll see you in Andromeda!